Hello, my name is Lourdes, and today I'm going to be interviewing Mr. Josh. So, hello, Mr. Josh.
Hello.
I'm going to be telling you a few questions today. So, the first question is, do you like being at St. Regis?
I do, very much so. You guys are wonderful, the kids are great, and the staff is wonderful. I love being here.
Okay. What's your second question? What's your favorite sport?
My favorite sport, I would believe, is college football. They have a very good competitiveness and a good team spirit.
Okay. Third and last question. What was your favorite subject growing up?
I would have to say math. I was very good at figuring out big numbers for some reason.
Okay, thank you. That's all for today.
Thank you, Mr. Josh.
Good morning, Mrs. Clark. Today I'm going to ask you a few questions about organization and study skills. I chose you to be on our broadcast because I know you are very organized and you teach study skills at the end. First question. Why do you think kids need to use a planner?
Well, as you know, Garrett, I am very much a fan of the planner because I think, especially in middle school, you really need to keep yourself organized. And the planner gives you the option of writing down every subject, what you have to do. And as you know, as I taught you, my suggestion is write it down in class, keep it with you all day, and at the end of the day when you're at your locker, you pull out your planner and make sure you take everything that you need. It's the perfect system.
All right, question two. How to organize your locker in the right way? Should you color code? Should you not?
I always feel like organization is a very personal thing. So for some kids, they like to put all the greens and all the yellows and all the reds together. Other kids like to do it by the hour. Some kids like to put all their textbooks together and then put all their folders and notebooks. My suggestion is you find something that works, and once it works, go with that.
All right. Third question, how should you study for a vocab test? Do you advise to use note cards or Quizlet?
Oh, wow, that's a good one. I don't advise Quizlet, but that's because I don't use it in my classrooms or my classes. I am a really big fan of note cards, as you know. I use them all through high school and college. I have had a student tell me that they don't use note cards and they're very successful in their academics. Mm-hmm. I do think note cards are wonderful because on one side you have a word and on the other side you have the definition. So you can study two ways. You can look at the word and then you can say the definition in your head, or you can look at the definition and then say the word. So I always advocate note cards because I think they're amazing.
Thank you, Mrs. Clark, for being on our St. Regis broadcast.
Thank you, Garrett. Have a great day.
You too.
Good morning. Welcome to our interview. My name is Melina M.
And my name is Grace S.
We asked our Academy Spanish teacher at St. Regis, Mrs. Hughes, for some information about her and her life. Here is what she told us. Mrs. Hughes' full name is Anne Gaddis Walker Hughes.
When she was in high school, she had a Spanish teacher that helped her believe that she could do anything she put her mind to. Her Spanish teacher made it so effortless that eventually she decided to make Spanish her focus while becoming a teacher. Because she was focused on Spanish, she also got to take advantage of many missions trips to Spanish-speaking countries, and that helped further her love of being able to speak another language.
She was born in Wisconsin, and she went to Iowa State University for college. Go Cyclones!
She has no preference for Michigan or Michigan State.
When she came here in 2014, she wasn't scared, but she definitely was nervous. Everything about St. Regis was the opposite of her school that she came from, and she was hoping that she would be able to do everything well.
Thank you for coming here, Mrs. Hughes.
Have you ever wanted to get something, except you couldn't find it at the store or it was too expensive? I know I've experienced the same problem. Well, you can just make that thing you want at home. With easy-to-find supplies you probably have at your house, you can make some of the coolest and craftiest items. I'm Zena, and now it's time for the weekly DIY, in which this week we'll be making a lava lamp eraser. For this DIY, you will need a Tic Tac container, hot glue, water, food coloring, and baby oil. First, what you want to do is take an empty Tic Tac container and fill up halfway with water. Next, add a drop of food coloring in it. After that, fill it up the rest of the container with baby oil. I used a turkey baster to put it in. After that, close the container and then add hot glue on any edge that you think any liquid will leak from. This will help seal the container. Then add hot glue to the top of the container and add your eraser on top. And now you have an awesome lava lamp eraser.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make DIY bath bombs. So, first what you're going to need is 1 cup of baking soda, 1/2 cup of citric acid, 1/2 cup of Epsom salt, 1 teaspoon of olive oil, food coloring, which is optional, a bowl, a whisk, a jar, a bath bomb mold, or if you don't know where to find a bath bomb mold, a chocolate mold. So, step one, place all your dry ingredients in a bowl and whisk them. Then, place all your wet ingredients in a bowl and mix them. Then, place them together and put it in your bath bomb mold. Let it dry overnight and you'll have wonderful, lush bath bombs.
So today, I'm going to show you guys how to make Lego gummies. So let's get started. Here are your ingredients. You need a box of Jell-O, corn syrup, 2 packs of gelatin, and 1 Lego ice tray. First, you're going to measure 1/2 cup of cold water, then put in 1/4 cup of corn syrup, then wait until it's dissolved. Then you're going to pour the liquid into a pot and add 2 packs of gelatin and the Jell-O, and then mix carefully until all gelatin is dissolved. Then you're going to turn on your stove to medium-low heat. Then you want to stir to about every 1 to 2 minutes so it doesn't burn. And then you're going to pour your syrup into your Lego tray, and then you're going to let them cool for about 5 hours, and then after that you'll have...
Hi, it's Anna, and today I'll be showing you a DIY form of wall art. Okay, here we go. Here's what you're going to need. You can go to Target, get some pictures that you can print out with you and your friends or family. Get some clothespins, some stringy lights, which are optional, and then you clip your string up onto the wall of your room or any office space or optional space, and finally string on the lights on this part of the clip so that they don't fall off, and just put your pictures right here and glue this part to your string, and plug in the lights, or unless you don't have any lights, and you'll have a DIY form of wall art in minutes.
Oh, I'm never motivated to finish my notes.
Are you serious? So am I. I came up with this light pack.
Really? What is it?
At the end of each section, place a piece of candy, and when you're done reading it, you can have a treat.
That's genius!
I'm so upset.
Why?
Because I always forget my pencil in my locker.
That's okay, I have a life hack for you. All you need is a pencil, a notebook, and a binder clip. So I already have the binder clip on, and I'm just gonna clip my pencil and fold the clips over, and there you have it. So you always have a pencil attached to every notebook.
Yay, now I'll never forget my pencil ever again in my locker.
Hi, I'm Joseph.
And I'm Ethan.
And this is the St. Regis weather at 10:40.
Today we're going to have sunny skies with a high of 80, and it's going to be a very nice day overall.
Here is our 5-day forecast. This weekend, look for the weather to have a chance of storms, a high wind in the mid-upper 70s. That's the St. Regis weather at 10:40.
Welcome to St. Regis Sports. In today's topic, we'll discuss Brother Rice and Regis football.
Brother Rice played Country Day and won by a score of 14. They are now 1-1.
In other football news, St. Regis versus St. Lawrence won by a score of 42. The top players were Colin, with 1 touchdown and 114 yards.
The CYR bracket for both Brother Rice and Regis is looking tough.
Thanks for tuning in to St. Regis Sports Network.
Good morning and welcome to our sports update. I'm Philip.
And I'm Patrick.
For this edition, we focused on volleyball and football here at St. Regis. For the volleyball interview, we spoke with Lucy Kay. What is it like being on the volleyball team? It's fun and you get to socialize with friends. How long have you played on the volleyball team? 2 years. When is your first game and who are you playing? Their first game was this past Friday against St. Anesthesia.
For our football interview, we spoke with Joey S. What position do you play? Defense and tight end.
What is the best part of football? Hitting and tackling. How many games have you played and who has been the toughest? We have played 2 games and the Holy Family has been the toughest.
Hi, I'm Lucy.
And I'm Jordan.
And we are going to show you
jokes, fun facts, and riddles.
Our first fun fact is,
there are more stars in the sky than there are grains of sand on every beach in the whole world.
Our next riddle is, why don't you give Elsa a balloon?
Because she'll let it go.
And our riddle is,
what travels around the world but stays in one spot?
A stamp.
That's it for us.
We hope you enjoyed Jokes Fun Facts.
Hello, my name is Jess Court, and this is the upcoming events. Our first fundraiser is Trunk or Treat, October 27th, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. We hope to see all of you there with your spooky trunks decorated. And also, don't forget to wear your Halloween costumes.
Hello, and welcome to Media Humor. Today, we're going to show you a cool math video. It's a parody. We'll be trying to post every week, so keep in touch. Here's the moment you've all been waiting for, Your Math Skills Are Terrible by One Direction. I'm your host, Maya O, and don't forget to include Mary S. from behind the scenes.
You're insecure, so hard for. Your old brains aren't up what they were before. And to